In actuality, if these individuals that were crossing would cross through the bridge, it wouldn't be a criminal crossing. It wouldn't be an illegal crossing. They could walk up to the bridge and ask for asylum, much like they do when they come to us. However, when they cross the river, then there's that added charge of illegal entry. So it is more beneficial for them to cross through the bridge as opposed to the river, not to mention the safety factor. What happens is these kids or these family units or even regular migrants, they're walking up to the bridge to claim asylum, and they get intercepted by the cartel members, the smugglers. And at that point, they take them to a certain area. They charge them and tell them when and where they're going to cross. The reason they do that is once they occupy us, we'll have to send multiple agents out there to ensure their security, their safety. And it opens up various holes along the border because our agents are having to come from other areas to secure them, to transport them, to make sure they're okay, make sure they're healthy, make sure they don't have any weapons, and get them into the station.
How often does that happen?
Every time they cross.
You have multiple groups every night?
Every night.
Every day?
Every night. It slows down during the week, maybe Tuesday, Wednesday, it's at its slowest. Thursday, it starts to pick up. Friday, Saturday, Sunday, it's just bodies everywhere. At our station, we're looking on the weekends, 600 to 700 a day.